When people think about overland travel, they typically think about a Land Rover cruising through either the outback of Australia or through the Kalahari in Africa. These vehicles are very capable and they're very refined and they have a great road ride. They really leave you with much less fatigue at the end of the day than would a solid axle leaf sprung vehicle. So there's some real advantages still to using these types of trucks. But one of the things that I think is most important that's happened in the last couple years with Land Rover is they've had a huge improvement in reliability. So tell me a little bit about some of the accessories that you've put on here. We've got a bunch of cool stuff. Let's talk about what you've added to the truck.
Kangaroo strikes are a real issue in the outback. So the very first thing that I would put on this vehicle, and I've certainly done this with all my vehicles, is fit the bull bar. I actually know of a discovery that actually hit a kangaroo out here in the outback. And basically the vehicle was immobilized, it had to be trucked back to Adelaide and was off the road for a couple of months. Now, the whole concept of the bull bar is obviously to protect the vehicle and prevent that from happening. And it certainly does that very, very efficiently. Obviously, it integrates very well with all the safety systems of the vehicle, provides a lot of protection for some of the underbody componentry, and also provides an ideal spot to mount things like the driving lights and the worn electric winch.
Looks like we have a snorkel fitted as well.
Well, absolutely. I mean, outback touring involves an awful lot of dust, and I do a fair bit of driving in the mountains around Victoria, in the southern states of Australia, and you know we've got quite a few river crossings up in the high country there, and you know, not particularly deep, but when you enter the river crossings, invariably you're going down a steep track, and the front of the car does have a tendency to sort of nosedive into the water, so I really like that sort of added protection that the
extra peace of mind.
Yeah, most definitely. What motivated me to do the rear bumper was I wanted to get the tire out from underneath the vehicle so I could fit a long range fuel tank. I mean, I'm carrying about 105 litres of extra fuel in the back of this vehicle, which really gives this Discovery an absolutely fabulous range. So with the rear bumper, I'm able to get the tire out from underneath the vehicle, make use of the space for the long range tank, and of course the rear bumper's got a range of other attributes as well. I mean, a lot of protection there. It's got high lift jacking points. I mean, one of the things I like about this car is that I can use a high lift jack off the bull bar, off the rear bar, so again, it's a lot of versatility there.
Yeah, and I found, having driven this vehicle now for a couple days, that small displacement V6 turbo diesel is just a beautiful motor. I mean, we were getting nearly 10 liters per 100K out of it, so excellent efficiency, and then it really felt great on the road. It really felt matched to this vehicle. It was like the perfect combination, not only getting some efficiency, but really good performance out of it overall. So clearly, this vehicle is not a Land Rover Defender, but I'm really impressed with what they've been able to achieve with these new platforms. Really good traction. We're able to lift the suspension and gain additional ground clearance just with a push of a button. It has a great low range, really good transmission, and overall a very refined and low driver fatigue ride. So I give this truck a good thumbs up, and look forward to testing it more out in the outback.